yun ang parang alone time namin.
But you know, I mean, yes, of course, majority of our lives is about sex, but we do make time. Like actually, yesterday we had a 2-hour break. We had a quick dinner, quick movie while he was sleeping down.
Yeah, yun mga quick date nights.
Quick date nights, mga
and
random
lunch dates.
And we don't plan that because we don't know also their schedules.
But
we definitely make time for each other. Because that's also very important. It's the married relationship. And there he said,
he mentioned before that he used to sleep on the floor.
No, he sleeps in the bed. I sleep on the sofa. Diba? Ito yung masters. Ito yung bed. Ito yung sofa. So, I sleep in the sofa because Sevi has his own bed on the floor. Because our bed is really, really high. And we've heard so many stories of babies falling in the bed. Wala akong kilalang isang mommy na nagsabi na hindi pa nahulog yung baby nila sa bed. And medyo mataas talaga yung bed namin. It's up to here. So pag nahulog si Sevi, ayun. Up to this day. Ganun pa rin ang setup namin. But when we travel, we sleep in the same bed. Very challenging. Ako, I think traveling with a baby is going to really test your relationship as a couple. It's a major test in the relationship of patience, understanding.
You really have to apply the word teamwork.
Yeah.
Because I can't expect the man to do everything, so it's a teamwork. So usually, while you know she's bathing him, you know I'm preparing his meal, his clothes, and when Sevi's sleeping, we're taking care of ourselves. So
actually,
it's teamwork talaga.
Yeah,
teamwork.
First time namin mag-travel with Yaya, nung Hong Kong lang, but yung Europe
when
trip
we went to
namin,
Europe, it was just us. So.
So talaga. Yeah,
but as much as it brings out a lot of course, the challenges are there. But it's worth it.
I think it was so tiring when we were doing it, but looking back, I was so happy with it. It was an experience that
and we're planning to
bonded
do more,
us
more traveling,
more
traveling.
As a family.
You guys already have a holy week and summer plans.
He was just asking me about it going here. What are our plans this holy week? PGT is going live on holy week, so we'll see what's going to happen. Live na kasi ang PGT next week.
So there's still work, of course, that you can only travel when there's big pockets, right? But when there's like 3-4 days, we try to do a quick trip. That's why we were able to go to Hong Kong last week.
Yeah.
Found, like 3 days free.
Are there any other countries that you want to bring Sevi to for specifically some?
We want to explore actually the states. We want to explore the states. We want to bring him to Colorado. We want to bring him to Hawaii.
LA, of course.
Because he we see a lot more of improvement to his motor skills, and there are milestones that nangyayari every time we travel.
So I think when we travel, we are able to open up his eyes to something new, so we think it stimulates not just his imagination, but his mind, his body. And
parang he's na nabagrow din yung horizon niya. So mas na, nagiging ano siya, mas, parang mas mabilis yung pagmamature niya as a baby. Yung nakaka-keep up siya. That one, sabi namin ni Paul, is something we don't want to close our doors, but if my opinion and my choice, of course, I wouldn't want to join the business. I would want him to pursue another, a different path, different career. But you know, I don't want to control him also. Or whatever it is that his heart desires, we will just support it fully. But you know, like what I said, we enroll him to different classes now. So, para mahanap na kung saan yung interest niya, yung passion niya, and we will take it from there.
For me, naman, I mean, whatever Sevi wants to be, we support 100%. I mean, we already understand that he is technically kind of already in show business. You know, he was born into it. So, as parents, that we're trying to manage it. We're trying to give him as normal a childhood as possible. So. That's why we like traveling. We can kind of be ourselves. Of course, Sevi's getting, he gets a share of pictures when we go out. And it's all new to him. So we try to minimalize it as much as possible. And it's see how he grows up, and eventually he'll have his own life, and he will tell us what he wants to do, and we'll support him 100%.
I guess because I've been here, parang feeling ko all my life. So, and I've been through so much in the industry, I know how it works. You know, I just want him to explore something different. But I don't want to see my child go through what I've been through. Because it's such a tough business and there's so much heartaches and pains and exposing him to that. But of course, as a mother, you want to shield him as much as possible. And I want him to grow up in a normal, in a normal setting, a normal life. I know it's hard, but we are trying our best to, you know, kind of way balance it. Now, yes, he's our son in a way, medyo napupunta siya sa limelight, but sana mas malaki yung part ng buhay niya na normal siya, yung normal yung childhood.
Toni, kanina ang Paul kind of verbalized the baby number 2, and you kind of shied away from it.
Because I'm very open to having another kid, but I'm telling Paul na when we're already para. Kasi Sevi is now at the stage na we are instilling yung good moral values, yung manners, and yung good conduct. So, I wanna focus on that muna before bringing another child para, alam mo yun, mas solidify ko muna yung foundation ni Sevi na yung core niya, mabuo ko muna. Kasi diba, ito yung formative years. Actually, 1 to 4 years old, from what I read, is the formative years, or 1 to 7 years old. So, I'm hoping na yung sa first 3 years, I could be there for him. Talagang personally, tutukan siya, and to instill in him yung good and more good moral values talaga. Before having another child. Kasi I will have to do it all over again.